Let me know when you can see the screen. You can see the screen, right?
Yes. Oh, yeah, to create VA01.
Yeah, I'm just creating a sales order. Okay. For a sample. I'm just entering the sold to party. I'm just entering the material code here. See, now you got to know, based on our previous class, how item category will be determined. You got it, right? Got it or not?
Yes.
Let me show you one thing. It's for a, let's it for a quick revision. I just copy one item category, and a copied item category, how it will be determined. Okay, that we can see for this document type. Let's go to the path. Okay. IMG. Now go to the sales and distribution. Okay. Go to the sales again. We are just getting into the sales documents. And within that sales document items, we have seen all the attributes related to item categories, right? Let me copy one item category like tan. So I can copy this one. Okay. I can copy it as a GTAN. Okay. If it is already someone has created, it will be like this. So GTTN, let me create this one. Okay. As of now, you say, you can say no or yes. It doesn't mean anything because there is one concept called copy control. Okay. And just saving this one. So let's click this one. Okay. So GTTN, if you want, you can change the text. That is a different story. So we have created one item category by copying 10. See, in your customer place, you might find some requirements, right? Okay. You got it or not?
Yes.
So for example, I will tell you one thing. I will tell you one requirement here for your understanding. So for this item category, so it is copied from TAN. So credit is active, right? Okay. When you are going to determine for your material, this item category, credit is active. But at your customer place, you found one strange requirement. Like, you know, for certain materials, you don't check any credit check. You can allow him to order. Maybe like, you know, slow moving items, like, you know, not that much influencing your organization revenue and all such kind of items. So if you determine with TAN, again for such kind of items also credit check will check, right? So as an value add, when you copy this one, so your TAN will work for your standard items. For those materials, it will be like credit check active, but whereas a GTTN, you don't require credit check active. You got it, right? I'm just telling one simple example.
Yeah.
Why we are copying and why we are doing. Like, I can tell one more example. Every time your customer is saying that, you know, it is not delivery related bill. Even it is standard item also, your customer is saying that it is based on order related billing. So you can see the C, B or C. Okay. So such kind of strange requirements, it will comes into picture. Most of the times, 70 to 80%, if you understand standard item categories, how it will work. If you come across any parallel scenario, business scenario, based on your material groups or some other scenario, then you have a think tank, like, you know, you people, consultants are sitting and discussing about that, and you just get into the conclusion how we have to do this. Now you understand my point, right? What I'm trying to say. Got it? This is how we are copying. Yes. Now let's go to the assign item categories. So basically, what is our document type? JEDVO R1, right? Okay. So let's try to delete all these item categories for JEDVO R1. Don't try to delete any other item categories for standard document type war and all. Okay. Because, you know, other guys will practice on the same system, right? So let's select this block. This is for selecting the block. Okay, let me delete this. I think probably it will be like more and more. Again, go to the JEDVO R1. So now select this. Select this. I can select this block. Okay. Let's delete this. Don't click this button accidentally also. It will delete for total entries. Okay. If you want to select the block. So this one is for, you know, selecting all your entries.
Select to all. Yeah.
Don't do that. Okay. This is for, you know, selecting particular block. This is for deselecting. Okay. Be careful with this. If you do unconsciously, what happens, right? Other guys also practicing on the same server will feel bad. Or else don't try this. You do it manually. Okay. If you don't have any problem, then. Let's delete this. You can select also manually like this. But I think, let's see how many entries are there for this JEDVO R1. Let's try to delete this. Now let's check again. So still more entries are there. So basically I copied my document type, right? Along with that, through copy controls, all these entries will be copied. Okay. Maybe more entries are there. Oh, I think it's less. I think everything is done for JEDVO R1. See, just wanted to show the difference, how it works, so what kind of error you will get it. Now let's try to create a sales order. Okay. So let's try to create a sales order with the material. See, you can see that no item category is available. Now you understand, right? Okay. Why we are doing the determination? You got it or not? Okay.
Yes.
I just deleted the entries. Now let's go back. Just go to the new entries. What is our document type? JEDVO R1. So in material master item category group is norm. Okay. So let's take item category as GTTN. This is our item category. Let me save this. I would like to add one more point. Like I'm adding manual item categories. Okay. TX, TAS, and TAN. Assume you are adding this one. Let's save this. Okay. Now let's try to create. See, when I wanted to default it, this is the item category. When I enter the material at line level of the sales order, immediately it will determine my default item category. See, now you are getting GTTN, right? Okay, because it is defaulted. Apart from that, you can able to choose manually according to the your business process. You can choose the manual item categories. Now you understand the point, right?
Yes, yes.
If you would like to do it on your own, any item category, you just copy and you can do it. See, initially you just try to determine the standard and then try to copy it. You can try like this. Okay. Now let's go to the next concept called schedule line category. Okay. If you double click here, you see this is the part related to your schedule lines. Schedule lines means it is going to determine your delivery dates schedule, as well as it is going to determine when it need to be delivered and how much quantity. In crisp, you can say that it is going to determine your delivery dates and, you know, your quantities, delivery quantities. Schedule line is going to determine. If you come here, okay, you can see the ordered quantity, rounded quantity, and confirmed quantity. Okay, certain cases you can able to split. It will be splitting like that. You know, if the stock is not available on the same day, it will be splitting and it is giving different delivery dates. So that functionality actually it need to be taken care by. There is one concept called availability check. We'll get into that. First, you try to understand what schedule line category will do. It will determine your delivery dates and your confirmed quantities. If you observe here, you can see that schedule line, right? This is schedule line category. So in this case, it is CN. Okay. That means no MRP. That means it is not going to check. It is not passing any requirements to your MRP. MRP means material requirement planning. This is one of the key integration between your SD and MM. So when you are determining schedule and category, which schedule and category, it will be determined based on the combination of your item category and MRP type. You understand my point?
Okay,
so let me show you how schedule line category will be determined. What are all the controls we have on schedule line category? I'm just trying to explain about, you know, important controls on schedule line category. When the time being, we'll get back to the schedule line category, how we are getting back to the document type controls and item category controls. So we'll get back to the schedule line category also. Because certain, see, if you would like to determine a certain quantities and delivery days, you required importantly you needed schedule and categories also. Okay, let's go to the path. Now I will show you where we are going to define schedule and categories and what is the relevance of it. Why it is linked to your item category, you have a doubt. Because it depends on your product, right? Got it?
Okay.
It depends on the product. For example, I will get into that one moment. I'll slowly get into that. Let me get into the path. First, see how the determination will happen. So let's go to the sales again, sales documents. You see schedule lines here, right? All three are there because all three belongs to your document type definition. Okay, three different sections. So if you see schedule lines, let's go to the assign schedule lines. Okay. So what are all the combinations we have? You have an item category and this is your MRP type. Okay. So which is going to be determine your schedule line category. Always you don't have a dependency of your material requirement planning check. Okay. Sometimes it can be blank also. So that means your item category alone can able to determine your schedule and category if your MRP type is blank also. Understand my point. Okay. So what is the schedule line category as of now we are getting for GTTN? Okay. Or else you can say in standard TAN, we copied because what we have for GTTN?
But Jagger, when we leave it empty so that it doesn't affect the MRP, whatever, we do it for what kind of, like, what's the objective? What kind of product can we use it for? Like,
for example, if I say for certain products, it is already always, you know, a lot of production stock is available for you. Okay. You don't want to plan it. For example, if you go for retail industry, okay, like Walmart, and if you go for future malls, different kind of malls will be there, right? When they're doing business with direct customers, they're getting the stocks from all your, what I would say, all your vendors, right? Okay. When you are keeping the stock, when you are, getting into the mall, suppose if you bought pair of clothes is already available. There is no point to raise request to your material requirement planning, right? It's not manufacturing. If some industry is not manufacturing, then you don't require MRP, right? Material requirement planning. Understand?
Okay. Yes, yes.
That is one way. Or else, if the stock is throughout 365 days, your production is more, then there is no point to raise material requirement planning, okay, for manufacturing and all. So then you can go for no planning. If you see here, this is the control will be there in your material master. I told you when we were discussing about material master, okay. So we'll get into this. What is this MRP? What could be the, you know, if it is not planned, like, you know, different options will be there. Okay. All these related to your inventory and material requirement planning. You got my point, right?
Yes, I understand.
Okay.
I understand.
Now, yeah. For your item category, talks about, you know, what kind of product it need to be determined at your sales order item level. Then what it talks about your MRP type, whether it need to be requirements need to be forwarded to your planner or not, it will be determined by this MRP type, okay, for that particular material. So schedule and category is talking about how it need to be delivered, or else it need not to be delivered. This is the definition, like item category, how we have attributes, like whether it is a third party sales item, or whether third party means like your vendor can directly deliver the stock to the stock to your customer, or else, you know, vendor directly deliver to the company. As a second step, company will deliver the stocks to your customer. Like different scenarios will be there. We'll get into that later. Okay. So this is schedule and category. That's why you will having a different schedule and categories. So currently you are getting this one, right? If you see sales order, okay, what you are getting? This one, right? CN. Let me open parallelly sales order screen. What schedule and category we are getting? Currently, you are getting what? You can see the sales order screen, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. When you are getting this one, okay. So, how you are getting for your item category. What is your item category? ZTTN, right? Let me go back to the schedule and category definition determination. You see, it is picking from here. ZTTN, what are all the item category, schedule and categories got assigned? CP. Okay, CP means your deterministic MRP. That means it will be moved to your planner and they will plan accordingly when the stock is available. Okay, you are checking in MD04 also, right? Okay, so like that, you have something called CV, different kind of schedule and categories will be there. So if it is consumption relevant materials, then you are going to select consumption MRP, and this is CS, this is for your third party, and this is for regular TAN material stock CP. And if you don't want to write,
just one question of curiosity, is this the way we use, for example, if we have products that, let's say we are waiting for certificates and it takes a long time, mm-hmm. And we don't know yet to when we will be allowed to resell, let's say, that particular item. Can we use it like this? Like, can we change it?
See,
from CN to CP?
These are the two things. CP, suppose your certificate, if it is a standard material, okay? Mm-hmm. If it is a standard material, then you are just waiting to, the stock need to be added to your inventory. Is it a stock? It's not a stock, right? Certificate is just a service material, I feel. You tell me, mm-hmm. It can be both the contexts.
No, let's say we have a material, okay. A finished good, a product, but it needs some certificates, for example, because of its use or because of, regular territory laws, let's say the European law or something like that.
Okay,
but it takes, let's say, long, and meanwhile you're not allowed to sell it without, let's say, the certificate.
One moment.
And you don't want to allow planning and dates while people input order.
Hello, I'm sorry, may I just okay.
It's okay.
So it is in two way. Okay, Josh. If you are waiting for your certificates, okay. Mm-hmm. The certificate is what kind of material? Is it bomb material? Like if you have a regular stock, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. For example, you are selling technical object. Technical mission.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. When you are selling one technical object, for that, you need some license or something like that. Certificate means it has a certain meaning, right? So if you are waiting, then that certificate is along with your material, right? Okay. So then you have to check for, when it can be in two ways. Like, if you are looking for the certificate is like a stock, our certificate is like just a service. Certificate is just like, your text material with stock. So you have to clear with your requirement. Then I can tell that everything will has a solution. See, if you say that last time we had a discussion at the time of discussing what I would say, your college prospectus, it is sellable, right? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So but
let's say if we have one particular item that takes very long to produce or to just sell, it takes maybe, let's say, 1 year.
Okay.
So whenever you need it, you wait for 1 year for, let's say, to have it, then that kind of product, do you allow planning for it?
Yeah, 100%. If it is manufacturing, then we have to raise that requirement for your MRP, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. License is something, how you would like to see the relevance in your business, okay? Along with the product you are waiting, okay? Or else your license, it is like, separate product you are adding, you are selling with the main product. Okay, so that customer need to clear, right? Well, that license is how should I look into that? when it comes to
no nature. let's say it's just a license for, you know, let's say you sell equipment, let's say for protection, you know, and they need to be tested and prove that they really protect people from this or that, you know, this kind of danger.
Oh, such and kind of thing. Then see, such yes. kind of materials, generally what happens, right? When we are, this is for, you know, your, this is rising for your MRP also, it has different facets actually. Okay. It is related to material management and inventory management. Then it will comes under your quality check actually. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
So QM is one separate module, that the QM integration should be needed for your material master. Okay. They will give for license in the sense, once you get the license, you are going to manufacture, or else after manufacturing, at the time of saleable, you are going to add a license. Okay. These are the two factors. So before you wanted to check, then MRP, suppose if it is raised to planner, then in the middle, quality inspection might be involved. You got it, right? That integration, MM and QM will take care. But the same license, if you are determining after, you know, manufacturing the product, if the stock is available, okay? Mm-hmm. Got it? So that is okay. Saleable license, right, with your product.
Yes.
You can say simply one thing as a requirement, but we should be clear with, like, you know, when the license needed, at the time of selling, or else at the time of purchasing, or else at the time of processing, after processed, before selling, we need, like that, you know, different contexts, it will comes into picture.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Okay. I understand.
When we are working with cross teams, right? Okay. You alone don't configure everything. We're just taking care of the sales. Okay.
Yes.
You got some points, or still you have doubts on your mind?
Yes, I got the point.
Okay. So when we are sitting with quality management, and when we are sitting with MM for discussions, maybe after you got a listen from your customer, okay, so we'll have a discussion, okay, what needs to be done. It's not like support. When you go for implementation, everything will be framed on your board. What solution we need to take care for this, okay? But sales side, you are completely responsible. What needs to be done? Understand?
Yes.
Okay. Let me get into this. Can you see my screen now? The session got expired. You can see my SAP screen or not?
Now, yes.
See, this is how we are going to see. For example, we'll go one by one, whatever the item categories we know. If you go for AFN, right? Okay. Your schedule and category is AT. Okay. If you go for AGN, you have something called BN and BV. We'll get into that, what exactly it is. Okay. So if you go for TAN, what is that schedule and category? CP and CN also there, sometimes CV also there. Okay, it depends on the MRP type, what you are going to, how you are going to pass the requirements to your planner. Now let's go to the item category called TAN. Okay, this is free goods item category. There also you can find the similar kind of schedule and category for determination. But we'll get into that slowly. Why we have this combination? Why we have this combination? Once you understand schedule and category attributes, you'll get into this. Okay, again, this part again. So in the meanwhile, let me try to create one enquiry to check this one up. What is the document type in standard? What is the schedule and category we are getting? AT, right? Okay. Now let's go to the quotation. Hello? Levy? Hello? Hello, Levy?
Don't tell me it's sleeping.
Okay. When you see here, we have a different scheduling categories, right? As of now, your sales order is picking CN. Okay. So we found the combination for item category. Okay. What is our item category? GTTN, right? GTTN, it is picking this combination. That means your MRP type somewhere it need to be get assigned. Okay. I will show you where it is assigned. Let's go to the sales order. Let's click Material Master. Okay. You can see here, right? Okay. ND, MRP type. Hello?
Yes.
I'm just sad that for this material 200, I don't require any planning. If I want, okay, my planning, like, you know, external planning, I can choose like this. If it is like, you know, deterministic MRP, that means the planning will happen within the unrestricted stock, I can go for it. Like that, you know, different things will be there. Okay, in your inventory management, maybe if it is forecast based planning for future stock, you can do that. Seasonal MRP based on certain first 6 months only, you are going to plan this stock based on the agriculture crop or, you know, products availability. Like that, you know, you have to choose according to your customer requirement. It depends on the product. Mm. It will decide what kind of planning you are going to do for your stock or inventory. You got it?